Hello, everybody. Welcome back. This is Amanda Rideout, health coach, and we are here again today with pharmacist Ben Fuchs, which is also a cosmetic chemist, a nutritionist, and a scientist, investigative scientist.
Good.
Is that right? I'm sorry,
Ben. I think you made it up, but I guess I know what you're getting at, and I approve.
That was crazy. Okay, anyway. Okay. Hi, Ben. How are you?
I'm good. Good to see you again, Amanda. And you look radiant.
Thank you.
Glowing. Good for you. Your skin has that beautiful look, that healthy, glowing look. I love it.
Yay. Thank you. Well, and thanks to your products and to the 90 Essential.
All of that.
Nutrients.
But we had good material to work with.
Oh, thanks. Oh.
It's true.
Oh.
That's true. Just keeping it real.
I have my mother to thank for that.
Probably.
Yeah. It's
a lot of it
yeah.
is you've got some good structure.
Yeah.
And we're going to speak about structure today.
Are we going to talk about retinol? Because last interview, we told everybody we would talk about that.
Okay, good. Well, yeah, I love retinol. Love retinol. Retinol is structural. We're talking about structure. Retinol is structural. And that's really what you're, when you use topical skincare products, you have a golden opportunity to affect the structure of the tissue. To really create beef. Remember how we always talk about beef?
Yeah.
To really beef up the tissue if you know what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And by knowing what you're doing, I'm talking about being able to leverage two very important nutrients, vitamin C and vitamin A. Remember, if you're stranded on a desert island, you can only bring two things on the desert island. If you only need two things, only have opportunity for two ingredients on your skin, you want it to be C and A. They are by far the gold standard of anti-aging and health ingredients. They're tricky to work with, and you got to know what you're doing. And most, unfortunately, you know, people who make skincare products aren't necessarily biochemically minded. They're more product minded. They're cosmetic yeah. chemists. They're making a product. They don't necessarily know how to manipulate biochemical tissue as well as they know how to make a beautiful product. I'm hedging a little bit because there's some overlap, of course. But you really need to have people who understand biochemistry, metabolism in the skin, how things happen in the skin, and understand cosmetic chemistry as well to create an effective skincare product. So here's the scoop on retinol or vitamin A. Because vitamin C, we've talked about, and I'm glad to talk about it again because I love it.
Sure.
But I don't want to say one's more important than the other. They're both probably equally important. But understanding how these things work is going to be instructive if we're going to really be able to exploit or leverage their power, their potency on the skin. So vitamin A. There's three main kinds of vitamin A. You've got the kind of vitamin A that the body transports the vitamin A molecule as. Vitamin A and the vitamins kind of travel through the body with an escort. And the first form of vitamin A that you'll find in topical skincare products is a form called retinyl palmitate. Have you seen this on ingredient decks? Retinyl palmitate.
Is that the red one? The one that's real red?
No. No, it's not
okay.
red. Sorry. Retinyl palmitate is the main form. It's R-E-T-I-N-Y-L, retinyl palmitate, P-A-L-M-I-T-A-T-E. And retinyl palmitate is the most common form of vitamin A in over-the-counter products. It's how the body, it's in the body as retinyl palmitate. It's how the body kind of protects the retinyl molecule. So it's biogenic in the sense that your body's making it, but it's somewhat inert. It has to be metabolized. It has to be chemically modified in order for it to be active. And the skin can chemically modify it, and some active vitamin A will be released out of that retinyl palmitate, okay? Now, that kind of vitamin A is cheap. It's not tremendously effective, but you'll get some vitamin A benefits. The second form of vitamin A is the most powerful form of vitamin A, and that's a form of vitamin A that is so powerful as an anti-aging product, what we call in the business a BRM, which stands for Biologic Response Modifier, basically something that modifies biology, that does something, basically something that does something. So in the skincare world, to find BRM is very unusual because by definition, a BRM is a drug because it's changing something in the body. So there's some exceptions to it, but retinoic acid is not an exception. Retinoic acid, which is the most powerful form of vitamin A, is a BRM that's so powerful it requires a prescription. And you got to go to the doctor's office, and it's a very, very ugly, formulation because it was made by a drug company, not by anybody who understood formulations. And they were just interested in making a drug. And they've tried to make it a little bit more cosmetically appealing, but it's just, it's an ugly product from a formulation standpoint. It's highly irritating. It's effective, very effective. In fact, it's almost like a must-have in terms of its effectiveness, but it's a pain because it's expensive. You got to go to the doctor's office. You got to go to the pharmacy. It's irritating. You got to be careful how you use it. So it's kind of a pain in the butt. Now, there's a middle form of vitamin A, which has some very interesting properties. So you got the kind of mild form that's in most over-the-counter products. You get a little vitamin A benefit from this form. You got the super strong form, the active form of vitamin A that requires a prescription. It's irritating to the skin, but very effective. And then you have a middle form. This middle form is called retinol. Okay? So you got retinyl palmitate, retinoic acid, and then the middle form, retinol. Now, retinol is very interesting. Retinol is actually in the skin. It's stored in the skin. In fact, you have more retinol in the skin than you have any other form of vitamin A, more retinol in the skin naturally than you do retinoic acid. It penetrates much more effectively into the skin than retinoic acid. It's not quite as potent as retinoic acid, but it doesn't cause the same kind of irritation as retinoic acid. The problem with retinol is it still causes irritation. Yeah. And so as important as it is, companies really don't want to mess around with retinol. They'd rather do the retinyl palmitate, or if they do a retinol, they'll put a little speck, a little dot of retinol, yeah. 0.01% or 0.1%, which is unfortunate. The studies that are done on the effectiveness of retinol, I'll tell you some of the benefits of retinol here in a second, but the studies that are done are typically done on around 1% retinol. So you need to have a good jolt of retinol, but most of the retinol you're going to get in department store products, salon products, is 0.1%, 0.2%, because it's irritating. Nobody wants to mess with it. And it's unstable, and nobody wants to mess with it. So what are the benefits to retinol and to vitamin A in general, but retinol specifically? Retinol, the benefits of retinol are really the same benefits that you're getting from retinoic acid and the same benefits that you would theoretically get from retinyl palmitate, but retinol is closer to the active form of vitamin A, the retinoic acid, than retinyl palmitate, and you can get retinol over the counter. So retinol has some benefits. Plus, as I say, it penetrates a little bit more effectively than retinoic acid, and it's in your skin anyway. So there's a lot of benefits to using retinol, but all of these things that I'm going to tell you about are pretty much vitamin A benefits for all three of these. Okay. So remember we talked about the beef, right?
Yep.
Retinol feeds the beef. It is the raw material for the beef. It turns on the beef. It turns on the beef. The beef is actually made from a special kind of cell called a fibroblast. You heard of that term?
Yep.
A fibroblast is a special cell. It makes beef fibers. Okay, I call it beef.
Human beef?
Yes, it's human beef. It's steak. How do you like that?
For anybody that's wondering what in the world is that, if you go to our first YouTube videos, Ben just dissects the layers of our skin.
It's the beef.
Yeah.
The beef. You got the beef, you got the candy coating, you got the sprinkles, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The beef is what we look at when we look at each other's skin, and you look like grandma's skin, or you can look like your little kid's skin, right?
Yeah.
You look at your little kid's skin, you're like, oh my God, it's beefy, it's solid, right? And then you look at grandma, not so much, right? It's thin, it's kind of wrinkly, and it hangs a little bit. The difference is the beef. So anything you do to build the beef is going to be in your interest, and vitamin A is fuel for the beef. It triggers the beef. It's a message, what we say in biochemistry, upregulation or an increase in beef production. It stimulates beef production from the fibroblast. But so what's beef? Well, beef is for one, collagen and fibers. And then beef is number two, this a spongy matrix that absorbs water. And it's made up of things that we've been talking about as sugars, long complex sugars, specifically these specialized long complex sugars that have little pieces of protein attached to them. And these long complexes of sugar and protein absorb water and give the skin a sort of spongy, bouncy quality that makes that is what we appreciate about our baby skin or what we want our skin to look like. And by the way, what your skin looks like, and I haven't seen you for a few months, but I imagine in person it's even more. It's even more noticeable and more significant because you're using the vitamin A.
Yeah.
So there's more benefits, but this is the main benefit. It builds the beef, right?
Mm-hmm.
It plumps up the beef. When the skin is plumped up, when the skin is beefy, it's not just appearance-wise. It's more resistant to injury. Mm-hmm. It's more resistant to environmental assault. It's more resistant to gravity. It's more resistant to all the things that cause aging. So the beef itself is nice to look at, but it also creates a healthier, more robust, and more vigorous skin system. It also creates a skin system that a stratum corneum, a surface Remember the sprinkles, yep. The stratum corneum. It also creates a stronger, more robust stratum corneum, which also has a protective benefit because not only does vitamin A and the retinoids, retinol in particular, affect the beef, it also affects the candy coating, which ultimately affects the sprinkles. And this effect on the candy coating is also very important. So number one, it's going to affect the beef. It's going to plump up the beef. It's going to give you a nice, thick, solid, strong look to your skin, like a anti-aging effect to the skin. But it also affects the candy coating, and there's a lot of benefits to affecting the candy coating too. So remember, just real quick review, you got your surface on this, I call it sprinkles, then you got the candy coating, and then you got the beef. The beef is 90%, the candy coating is like maybe 9.9%, and then the sprinkles are like 0.1%. The sprinkles, we call that the stratum corneum, and that's like fingernail. That's like a fingernail, very thin layer of fingernail on the surface. Can you imagine that? Mm-hmm. Very microscopic layer of fingernail on the surface. It creates a barrier and makes the skin stronger. That fingernail is derived from the cells of the candy coating that are rising upward. That's called the cells are called keratinocytes or skin cells. We'll call them skin cells. And as they're moving upwards, they're journeying upwards from the bottom of the candy coating. That's called the epidermis, that candy coating level. Their ultimate fate, their ultimate destiny is to be a fingernail on the surface and then to ultimately flop off. Now, the benefits that we just talked about, those are in the 90%, the dermis, the connective tissue, the stuff that gives the skin a sort of bouncy quality. But you can do a lot for the candy coating, for the epidermis. For example, by speeding up the movement of cells, vitamin A speeds up the movement of cells upwards, you're helping shed pigment. So vitamin A, retinol, is a wonderful anti-pigmenting agent. Mm-hmm. By speeding up the movement of cells from the bottom to the top, you're increasing moisture factors because cells secrete moisture factors as they're moving up to the top. So you end up with moister skin, more hydrated skin, softer skin. And because you're speeding up the movement of cells from the bottom to the top, you're ending up with, as we said earlier, a more robust and vigorous stratum corneum. So you're getting all of these tremendous benefits from one nutrient. And this is all voluminously researched in the literature, tons of literature. You just get on, you know, scholargoogle.com and look. It's zillions of articles on topical retinoids and retinols and all of the things that they do. So you're getting stronger beef. You're getting thicker, stronger, more powerful skin. A skin that's more able to withstand environmental assaults, a better looking skin. You're getting skin that has more of the spongy factors that trap water. You're getting a stronger, more robust surface on the top. You're getting moisturized, hydrated skin as the cells are moving upwards from the bottom to the top. You're getting a healthier skin on almost all levels, more even tone, stronger skin. I mean, every single marker of what we want in a skincare product, you're getting with this ingredient. But you have to bypass a couple of hurdles. Okay, number one, you need to have high concentrations, and high concentrations can be irritating. So that's hurdle number one. Hurdle number two is retinol is unstable. It breaks down over time. So it's hard to get it in a product that you can deliver to the skin because it's going to break down. It breaks down sometimes very, very quickly. So you've got the breakdown product, you've got the irritation product, and then you've got the expense product. It's very expensive to work with retinol. Excuse me. So you've got some hurdles that you got to jump through. Probably the most significant is the irritation. So what I did is I figured out a way to make it not irritating. I figured out a way to create a product that's 5% retinol, 5%, which is five times as much as you see in the studies, and 50, and you know, 500 times as much as it's in a lot of skincare products.
Oh my gosh. All right?
And it's stable and it's not irritating. And on top of the retinol, because the second important ingredient that's very important with retinol is vitamin C, I put a whole bunch of vitamin C in there as well. So it's a combination of retinol and vitamin C, and I recommend people use it once or twice a week. But it is a high concentration of retinol, and some people, I think you're using it more than once, or you were using it. I think you got carried away with it or something.
I'll tell my story after this.
Tell your story. Yeah. Let me give you a couple more miscellaneous benefits, because anti-aging is just one, and skin lightening, of course, is another. Yeah. But it's also, retinol is also helpful for acne for a couple of reasons. Number one, it helps reduce or eliminate even what's called post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, which is a type of skin darkening that occurs after you have a zit. You know what I'm talking about? Or after I have a cut or scrape or wound or whatever. But after a pimple, after a blemish or zit, a lot of people get dark spots. If you use retinol, that doesn't happen. The second thing, if you use retinol on a regular basis, because retinol is speeding up the movement of cells upwards towards the top, your skin cells, your follicles, don't get a chance to get clogged up.
So
you don't get blemishes that, if you use it on a regular basis, you don't get blemishes that you ordinarily would get. And if you have blemishes, because the vitamin A is speeding everything to the top, the blemishes disappear much more quickly. So it's a wonderful, wonderful anti-acne treatment.
Okay?
So it's skin lightening, it's anti-aging, it's anti-acne, and retinoids are great for psoriasis. In fact, they're prescription drugs for psoriasis. So using this retinol product that I have, or any really retinol product if you can find high concentration, is great for dealing with psoriasis, preventing it from occurring, and speeding up its healing, because it's speeding up the movement or the sloughing off of cells off of the surface. And then interestingly, there's a lot of literature on topical retinol for cellulite. And when you think about it, it makes perfect sense, because cellulite is caused by connective tissue breaking down, usually due to toxicity and water and, you know, metabolic imbalances, changes in chemistry. But one of the major signs or one of the major features is the connective tissue breaks down. And that's what that orange peel look is. It's seeing the breakdown of connective tissue with fluids that are leaking in. Retinoids help build connective tissue. So there is literature that talks about using it for cellulite. I'm not saying it's a dramatic, it's a cure for cellulite, because cellulite is a sign of bodily breakdown and toxicity, but there is literature to support its use for cellulite, and that makes perfect sense. So when you're using your retinoids topically, and by the way, you want to make sure you're taking internal retinoids too, internal vitamin A, okay, not just using retinoids topically, but like we talked about a lot, when you're deficient in nutrients, the skin is the first place those nutrients are going to come out of. So using nutrients topically can allow you to bypass that pulling effect that the body has on sucking nutrients out of the skin. You can kind of replace some of those nutrients that are lost, and vitamin A and vitamin C are two of the most important ones that you want to replace, the two most important ones that you want to replace. So lots of amazing reasons to use retinoids or to use retinol. Our product is 500 times stronger than anywhere from 100 to 500 times, I'll say, stronger than the typical retinoid product. Even if you use 1%, if you could find a 1%, I don't know of any 1% retinol products, and that's what the studies are on, this is 5%. So,
wow.
It's a great product, and that's what you're using. I want to hear your story.
Okay, so when you sent me that sample, I got very excited. And so you said you sparingly and use just, you know,
twice a week.
You know, I have little splotches here. And so I started putting it all over. And then all of a sudden I was like, well, I've got more splotches here and here and here and here. So I ended up using it twice daily for a week.
Yeah, that's a lot.
And I had not noticed any irritation. If anything,
that's amazing. Used it twice daily for a week, and you noticed no irritation. That's amazing.
No.
That's amazing.
But then, after that, I think it sort of caught up, and I don't know. But then
you overloaded it.
I overloaded, and it irritated this, and then it irritated right here, to the point where it sort of seemed like a light burn. You know,
right.
It just got dark, and then you sent me the
omega-6 healing cream
that. Speed, it just, everything.
That stuff's amazing, right?
Yeah, it is amazing. That's why I was like, I want more of that.
Yeah.
But now I use it every other night just on my little splotches, and I use it twice a week as an all-over.
Good.
It's my moisturizer at night.
Perfect. You notice your skin is moister and more hydrated?
Oh, my gosh, yes.
Right.
It, with just a tiny little bit, and then I put it all
and
over
my
face.
And it's not like it's moisture hydrated because of the product. It's not like you're feeling the product.
No.
You're feeling your skin. Your skin is moist and hydrated.
Yeah, it just, I go to bed, and in the morning, I will say this so that everybody sort of knows, it is, like you said, it's a strong product, and it helps.
Once or twice a week.
Yeah, in the morning.
But on the dark spots, you can use it a little bit more.
I do that a little more. I'll wake up in the morning, and I'll feel a little bit of dryness, or sometimes I'll notice a little bit of peeling. You can't even notice it unless you do a magnifying glass. I'll wash my face. I'll put on my regular, either the omega-6 cream, or I'll do the Truth Day serum, and then it's normal. So it's what you once told me it's a peeling, like
it's sloughing the pigment off. Mm-hmm. Now, so if your pigment was a 10, what a month ago or whenever you started, what is it now?
It's so hard to tell when you're looking at yourself, but what I can say is this, that it doesn't jump out anymore.
Okay. You notice that there's a difference.
I do. And I do commercial acting. And whenever I had to go into auditions, my biggest worry was I put so much makeup on and they're going to see this big splotch right on my cheek. And I could never cover it up. And you see, now I don't even feel like it's noticeable like that anymore.
Awesome. That's awesome. Yeah. And your skin looks beautiful too, by the
way. Thank you.
You're glowing. I love that look.
Yay.
All right. Good. All right. So you know what, by the way, I should tell you, I did say always damp skin, right?
Yes.
You know, always damp skin. But on the spots, you can do something called occlusion. Have you heard of that term? Occlusion is when you cover it up with a Band-Aid or something, and you'll get deeper penetration of the retinol.
Really? With spots. A Band-Aid?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now you got to be careful though, because you're going to get more effect.
Yeah.
Be careful.
I'm going to go to bed full of Band-Aids. My husband's
just a couple. What? Just one. No, because you don't have that much. Just
no.
One over here, one over here, and one over here, right? I think you had one.
Yeah, I have here. Yeah, when I was a teenager, they started out as freckles, and then they just sort of grew.
Really? It's helping lighten those? Because usually it doesn't lighten those.
Yes. These big splotches were the ones that I think appeared years ago and then just got darker and darker and darker.
Okay, so that's pigment.
Yeah.
So, all right, well, we'll keep tabs on it.
Absolutely.
All right.
Thank you, Ben. Everybody, hold on. I do want to ask you this.
Yes.
I've had some questions. People have been emailing me back, and actually I've gotten some calls also about where can I get these products.
You know what? It's going to have to tease it a little bit longer. The website will be up here in a couple weeks, two, 3 weeks. You know, these things always... There's some kind of law. I don't know if it's Murphy's or Patrick's or Peter's or whoever's law it is. It's a law, whatever it is. If it's not, I'm going to name it. Things always take longer than you think they were going to take.
That's Ben's law. Let's coin it Ben's law.
Always take longer. If it's supposed to take a month, then count on two.
Yeah.
By Ben's law.
Okay. So what we'll do is we will keep people posted on these videos. So everybody stay tuned. And the day they are available to the public, we will announce that.
Good deal.
Okay.
Good deal.
All right. Well, thank you so much. You have a wonderful week.
Thank you. Good to see you again.
Good to see you. Bye.